Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to thank both of our witnesses for being here today. I'd like to turn our discussion to the campaign to remove career diplomat Ambassador Yovanovitch. Both of you, in your various capacities, had to work with her, and both of you witnessed what I would call a smear campaign. I wanted to know your thoughts, Dr. Hill. What was your view of Ambassador Yovanovitch's experience and quality of her work in the Ukraine, and do you consider it to be a smear campaign?
I have the highest regard for Ambassador Yovanovitch, both in terms of her integrity and the high standards of work that she was carrying out as ambassador in Ukraine and across her whole career. I do believe that there was a smear campaign, and I just want to say, again, for the record, that I think it was unnecessary. If there was a decision to have a political ambassador put in place in Ukraine, that would be perfectly acceptable. It's exactly the right of the president to be able to do that. I did not see why it was necessary to malign Ambassador Yovanovitch to such an extent.
Mr. Holmes, would you agree with that? And can you talk about the character, integrity, and performance of Ambassador Yovanovitch, both in Ukraine?
Yes, ma'am. She was extremely professional, respected in Ukraine by Ukrainians, I think also by visiting American senior officials, including members of this committee and of Congress who came to visit. She was extremely dedicated, hardworking.
Did you see it as a smear campaign as well?
I did, yes.
And what was the effect that it had on the morale of other professionals that you worked with in the Ukraine?
It was a very confusing time. As I've said before, the president has the right to remove an ambassador for any or no reason at all. It was not clear to us why this was happening or why people weren't standing up for her.
I'd like to now turn, Dr. Hill, to your boss. Your boss was Ambassador Bolton, right?
That's correct, yes.
Did your boss, Ambassador Bolton, tell you that Giuliani was, quote, a hand grenade?
He did, yes.
What do you think he meant by his characterization of Giuliani as a hand grenade?
What he meant by this was pretty clear to me in the context of all of the statements that Mr. Giuliani was making publicly, that the investigations that he was promoting, that the storyline he was promoting, the narrative of he was promoting was going to backfire. I think it has backfired.
Was that narrative also inclusive of falsehoods about Ambassador Yovanovitch?
At the particular juncture that Ambassador Bolton made that comment, absolutely, because that was in the context of my discussions with him about what was happening to Ambassador Yovanovitch.
I was particularly struck by your testimony, Dr. Hill, about receiving hateful calls and being accused of being a Soros mole in the White House. Are you a never-Trumper, or have you been true to your profession and remain nonpartisan?
I honestly don't know what the definition of a never-Trumper is, as I think many of my colleagues are feeling the same way, that it's a puzzling term to be applied to career or nonpartisan officials. And I chose to come into the administration. I could easily have said no when I was approached
yes, by the people. Yes, but you didn't sign up to have hateful calls and the like.
I guess, unfortunately, where we are today in America, that's coming with the territory. They're continuing, honestly. I mean, we're constantly having to block Twitter posts of my name and address and on the internet. We've been doing this over the last couple of days.
I think that you
And as I agree. Said in my deposition, this could happen to any single person in this room, be it members of the press, be it members of Congress, and be it the staff. And I think we have to find ways of combating this. And again, this gets back, sadly, to things that our adversaries can also exploit.
Exactly. I think you would agree with me that this shouldn't become the new normal. Would you agree?
It should not.
I also think that this kind of behavior, instead of keeping you down, would make you undeterred. Are you more determined to continue to do your work and to do it professionally?
I am, and I think that all my colleagues are as well, because just as you said, we can't let this stand, and I don't think anyone here wants to let this stand. I actually don't believe that this is a partisan issue. I don't think anybody wants to come under personal attack.
Yeah, I unfortunately think that this has become the new norm, and we're being led by the very top of the food chain, which is our president, which is unfortunate. I'm especially disheartened by his treatment of women, and I think that the fact of the matter is that there's a long line of strong, talented women who have been smeared and victimized by this president, and we can either choose to ignore it or do something about it. And frankly, I think that whether you voted for him or whether you supported him or not, that doing so is wrong. You could simply just remove someone. You don't have to smear them. Thank you, and I yield back my time.